No, we're going out there and we're doing our best, doing the best we can do right now. But I think we could be a lot better.
Xavier, what's the story on the different colors of your hair? It's a pretty cool look.
Well, I did this like a little while back in high school. I just thought it was something different for me to do. You know, me and my brother, we kind of had sat down and talked about it. Because I know I wanted to do something different with it, but I didn't know what exactly yet. So we came to the conclusion to kind of, you know, do it half and half with the blonde and the black side.
So did your brother dye it?
Nah, he didn't dye it. I went to a beautician my mom goes to. So I went there and kind of got it done.
Who does it here in Tuscaloosa?
Nobody. I always go back to the crib when I got to go redo it, yeah.
What's your brother's name?
Brandon McKinney.
Brandon.
Yeah.
How often do you have to redo it?
Not super often, because if I do it too much, then my hair probably fall out, just because it's the blonde. So, you know, when I'm bleaching it, so I can't do it too much or it'll come out.
What do the girls say?
They like it. Everybody like it, yeah.
Anything else?
Not to change the subject, but Coach Saban pointed you out as one of the leaders on that defense. He's been pleased with the communication. How do you grow into a leadership role here? I mean, what's that responsibility like when you take that next step?
Well, for me, I feel like I've always been a leader, or at least always tried to be a leader. So for me, coming into that role, it wasn't too hard for me. Of course, it's a little bit challenging just because the people that are around here and just knowing that everybody, you're not the only person that is really good. So. Knowing that it's a lot of other people that are really good, just like you. So those can be the, you know, some challenges of becoming that leader and stepping into that role. But I thought I've always been a great leader, and just coming into that role has helped me out and it's helped me grow as a player and as a person.
So with so many freshmen out there, like, what are you telling everybody play-to-play basis? Like, what's your responsibility? Is it different with some of the young guys?
It can be. You know, just trying to make sure that we're on the same page. Just trying to make sure that they know what's going on around the whole field. You know, sometimes I just kind of talk to them, give them like tips on, you know, what I think might be coming. So just making sure that we're all on the same page is some stuff that I try to make sure I tell them, and just try to make sure they're as calm as possible so we play as well as we can play.
So Henry, biggest game of your career so far, man. I mean, it's been a pretty crazy ride, at least up to this point. You know, I mean, it seems like everybody's getting involved, everybody's passing the ball around. But how much fun did you have out there doing what you did?
I mean, it was fun. Of course, you know, you want to have success in the game, coming from, you know, the things that we're doing in practice and just working hard. But I mean, those things did happen. But I kind of focused on the things that I didn't do that well.
Things are those?
Just the run game. I mean, as an offense, I feel like we still have work to do, and on the perimeter we had one of our worst games blocking.
Have you been back home to see Lee playing this year?
Not yet.
Doing pretty good in 7-8.
Yeah, I've been seeing him, you know, keeping up with him, but I just haven't had a chance to go see him with my own eyes.
You feel like you can take one to the house all the way on any given play? It's a lot of yards after catches with the way this offense works sometimes.
I mean, Coach Wiggins just harps on getting north and south when we catch the ball, and that's just a big thing. So once I catch it, I'm more of a straight line runner. I know that's where my speed comes in, so I'm going to run downhill, and whenever I see a crease, I'm just going to hit it. And knowing, like I said, that I have speed, I just trust it to make the play.
What is your fastest 40 time? What's the average? You know, like, if you just do it consistently, hey, I can go out today and I can run this. What's your fastest? What's more of an average?
Well, the fastest was the 4.25, obviously. But, I mean, they're all hand time, so I really don't say I have an official 40 time. So, you know, on hand time, average from anywhere from 4.2 to low 4.4.
What's it like to be that fast?
I mean, I don't know, it's fun just like when we in the room, we just seeing like guys break open and break away, and I always call everybody slow and they just be like, well, I'm not slow, you just fast, you can't call everybody slow. So, I mean, that's fun with everybody, and just watching, like when we watch my plays, I can tell them like I didn't feel like I was running that fast, but they look at it like, what you looking at? So, I mean, it's always fun.
Who's your biggest competition on the team for speed?
Speed? It all depends on the race. I mean, Devontae, he got the long stride and he has a long endurance. So if it's a long race, he probably got it. But Waddle is one of the best sprinters too.
During the game, is it more verbal between you and the opponents, you and your teammates, or is you kind of a quiet guy? Don't really say a lot during the game?
I mean, I don't say much. If something said to me, then I mean, I might reply back just some subtle, but not much. I'm not much of a trash talker. But, I mean, most conversation just stays between me and my teammates. We just keep each other up, you know, encourage each other during the game.
Is there a trash talker on offense?
Is there? I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody can be. I'm pretty sure anybody can be at any given time. But I think it comes from more if it's fuel. It's not that we'll just go out and talk trash to anybody. That's not something we do.
Is that something Coach Saban and the defensive
side
of?
Yeah, I mean, Coach Saban always says we never talk to the other team. You never try to, like, you know, down anybody else for anything you do. You just go out there and make your plays and let your game do all the talking.
What's the biggest difference from sophomore to junior year for you?
Just focus. Focusing on details, focusing on technique, and being more of a student in the meetings. So you just learning and seeing what the defense are doing, what they're trying to do, and what kind of things they're trying to stop.
Your SEC home opener, competition steps up a little bit. What do you see from the Ole Miss defense?
I mean, it's an SEC opponent, regardless of, you know, what type of things you've seen on film, what flaws you think they may have, you're gonna come in, they're gonna give you their best shot. So we have to be clicking on all cylinders and ready for four quarters.
I know you're on offense, but how have you seen the game slow down for Christian Harris a little bit?
Christian, that's a guy I literally talk to every day. I got him in one of my classes. So, I mean, I just talk to him and make sure he's not nervous or nothing about anything. And at first, you know, going into the Duke game and the second game, he was really nervous. He's just coming into class telling me, like he really couldn't focus on school because he was more thinking about football. But I'm telling him, like, you've been playing football all your life. The field's not going to change, you know. Nothing's changing, you're just in a bigger stage and more people watching. So, I mean, you can tell that the game's slowing down. He's starting to make more plays and become more of a factor on the defense.
As far as the DBs go, mm-hmm. We watch y'all, you're in practice a lot, y'all go up against a lot of these younger guys. Do you do a lot of coaching to those guys as far as you see stuff they're doing wrong or you leave it up to the defensive side?
I mean, yeah, we kind of coach each other a lot of things. They know a lot of the things we do. We know a lot of the things they do. So, you know, say if I beat them one time on the route, I tell them, you know, like, hey, you did this. This how I got inside, but I wasn't supposed to get inside. And sometimes they'll give us tips, like if we don't get off a release, they'll tell us why or things like that. So we kind of coach each other and help each other out.
4 weeks into the season, can you kind of give me your personal assessment of the defense and where you guys need to go?
I feel like as a defense, we've been doing great as a unit. We've been communicating well on the field, you know, been making plays on the field. And I feel like at this point in the season, we've been flying around to the ball and just playing our best as a whole team.
On a personal level, anything you think you need to work more on? How do you grade yourself so far?
I grade myself, you know, getting better each week. You know, I still got stuff to improve on, you know, knowing different things throughout the game, you know, just playing my game, you know, just knowing what I have to improve on to work on my game and get better each week. So that's what I'm focusing on.
The SEC home opener competition level steps up. What do you see from the Ole Miss offense?
I see that they put up points on the board. They have a great offensive scheme. You know, they throw the ball a lot. They basically have great, they got good perimeter receivers. You know, we just looking forward to the game and just stopping them from doing that.
How helpful is it to you that your father, obviously a longtime NFL player, watches you? How much feedback do you get? How helpful has he been in the process?
He's been helpful for me throughout this whole process. He's very aware of what school I'm at. Alabama, you know, is a big time school, but he gives me the same basic subjects every day, just play your game, know what to do out there and just have fun. So, you know, he's been a big contributor to my success, and I look forward to just talking to him even more on the field.
What was that like growing up and living in that type of environment?
What'd you say?
Knowing your dad and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about what was it like to be in that type of environment periodically and stuff?
The environment was great, just seeing him play on the field, you know, just learning from him what he does on the field. And ever since I was younger, I knew I was going to be a football player one day. But just looking at it from his side of the game, you know, it just made me think, like, man, I could probably do something like that one day. So, you know, it's just great to have him on my side every day. So, you know, back to my younger days, you know, I just thankful to be in that position.
Where have you seen Coach Golden kind of take the next step in making sure y'all are in the right position? What have you seen from Coach Golden?
Coach Golden is a great coach. You know, he's bringing out the best of us as a unit. You know, he's a great defensive coordinator. You know, he just makes sure that we stay on task, on top of things, knowing what comes before the offense gives it to us. You know, he's a great coordinator.
Coach Saban, Xavier and Anthony were kind of stepping into the leadership void among the linebackers. What do you see those guys do to kind of be leaders on the field?
You know, I've seen them step up, you know, whenever they talk about doing something, you know, they play step up, you know, whenever they expect the defense to do better, you know, you can see it in them. You know, they are two alpha dogs on the team, and, you know, they special players on the unit.
Coach,